We continue now at the top of Daf Lamed Vav and Beis Masech Shabbos. This is Shabbos Daf 36b. The Gemara just said that nowadays what used to be called Bavel is called Borsif, and what used to be called Borsif is called Bavel. And the Gemara says Lamai Nafka Mina. What difference does it make? Legitei Nashim. The difference it makes is for Gitei Nashim, for divorce documents. And Rashi explains Legitei Nashim. The Kaim Alon, because we hold Bnei Bavel Bekiin. People from Bavel are experts. Shetzarach Lichtov Get Lishma. They know that a get needs to be written Lishma. And therefore, somebody who brings a get from Bavel ain't sarach lomer b'fanei nechta b'fanei nechtam. He doesn't need to say b'fanei nechta b'fanei nechtam. He doesn't need to certify that it was written properly. Uvenei shara rotzas ain't b'kiyin v'tzarech. And people from other lands, they're not experts at get, and therefore there is a requirement when a get is delivered from those areas to say b'fanei nechta b'fanei nechtam. So now it makes a difference where these locations exactly are. V'achshav b'nei borsif hi Bavel. Now the people of Borsif, that's actually Bavel. Bavel shall achshav, and what we call Bavel nowadays, he Borsif, that's actually Borsif. Vehein Amearitz, and the people from that area are Amearitz. Kedamin and Bialim, as we say in Sanhedrin, Bor Shafi shenat lumeimav. What's why is it called Borsif? It's called Borsif because they're like pits without water. It's a land full of Amearitz. So that's the first explanation of Rashi, that the difference is whether or not you need to say b'fanei nechta b'fanei nechta. Va'ani omer, and I say a different pshat. Rashi himself says a different pshat. Nafkamina legite nashim le'inyan shina shmo shema v'shem iro v'ira. There's a halacha that you have to write the proper names in the get and the proper names of the cities in the get. So if you change the names, it's puzzle. V'tzarech lichtov shem shel achshav. The requirement is to write the name that it's called now. You don't write the name of the place that it used to be called. You write the name that it is called currently. Hadron Aloch B'mem Adlikin, we should return to you, Perek B'mem Adlikin. That brings us to the end of the second Perek of Masechet Shabbos. We're about to start the third Perek. I don't usually interrupt the reading of the daf, but I'll just note at the end of Prakim, as I usually do, that if you want to see how you can support this channel, you can please look at the bottom in the description box, and you can see various ways to support this channel. We now begin the third Perek of Masechet Shabbos. This is Perek Kira. So the Mishnah says, Kira, if I have a stove, or an oven, we'll see in Rashi, sheisikua bekashu v'gvava. If the fuel is straw or stubble, so then nosnim olea tavshil. You're allowed to put a cooked item on it. You're allowed to put something that you're cooking on top of such a stove. Begefes uve'etzim. However, if the fuel is gefes, which is, Rashi says it's the psolus of sesame, or if you're using wood, so if it's an oven that is using wood as its fuel, lo yiten, you're not allowed to place any cooked food, ad sheyigrof or ad sheyiten es ha'efer, until you sweep away the coals or until you put some ashes on top of the coals. Beishamai omer beishamai say chamin. Beishamai say even in such a situation, you're only allowed to put hot water on. Avalo tavshel, you can't put other cooked items. Ubeishil alom beishil say chamin v'tavshel. When we say it's permissible, it doesn't matter if it's hot water or some other item that you're cooking, it is okay. And then the Mishnah concludes, Beis Shammai Omrim Notlin Avalo Machzirin. Beis Shammai say it's okay to take stuff off the flame on Shabbos, but you cannot return it to the flame on Shabbos. Beis Hillel Omrim Af Machzirin. Beis Hillel says you're even allowed to take something that you took off the flame, you can return it to the flame. So the beginning of the Mishnah was discussing putting an item on the stove before Shabbos and letting it cook on Shabbos. And the end of the Mishnah is discussing whether you can return that item to the flame on Shabbos. Taking a look at Rashi over here, Rashi says, Kira, what's the oven? Asuya kein kedera v'nosnim kedera l'socha. The kira was made it looked almost like a pot. It had the shape of a pot, and they would place a pot inside of it. Kash is zanvas hashibol, and that refers to straw. Givava hanigvav min hasode is stubla. That's a stubble. Gefes psoles shal shumshamin shahotzi shumnan. The gefes refers to the leftovers of sesame after you've taken out the oil. And then the Mishnah said, ad sheyigrof hagecholim. You're only allowed to place something on that oven if you sweep aside the coals, mishum demosif hevel, because otherwise heat is added, or rather because these fuels add heat. V'taima parishna v'perek d'le'el shem yechta v'gcholim. Why do you have to sweep aside the coals? The issue is we're afraid you're going to stoke those coals. O'ad sheyiten efer and other possibilities, you could place ashes on top of the coals, agabi g'cholim on the coals, l'chasosim to cover them, u'letzanim and to cool them off. So now the Mishnah said, Beis Shammai omrim nosen ala chamin achas shagarfa. So Beis Shammai say that you're allowed to place hot water after you sweep aside the coals. The lo tzricha levashule, because it's hot water, doesn't need to be cooked. The lekel lemigzer shemiyachta, so there's no real problem that you might stoke the coals. Avalo tavshel, but not an item that needs cooking. The nichole bishule, meaning something that you actually wanted to improve with the cooking. Then you're going to come to actually stoke the coals. Inami neskaima machshavto. Or Rashi says the problem, according to Beis Shammai, is it looks as though you're cooking. When you're putting just cham in hot water, it doesn't look like you're cooking. Here it looks like you're cooking. Then the issue in the Mishnah, the last issue in the Mishnah, was whether you're allowed to return it to the stove on Shabbos or not. So Beis Shammai say, lo machzirin v'Shabbos de michzik mevashel. You can't return it because it looks like you're cooking. And Beis Hillel say, af machzirin hol v'garf. Since it's already garf, you can return it. So again, according to Beis Shammai, you are only allowed to place chamin before Shabbos, and you cannot do any returning to the fire. And according to Beis Hillel, you're allowed to return things to the fire, and it's not only by water, it's by other cooked items as well. The Gemara now says, Iboilu, they ask the following question. Hai lo yitein lo yachzeru, avalishos mashin. When the Mishnah says you can't place it on the fire, was it talking about not returning it to the fire? But everybody would agree that you can put it on the fire before Shabbos, afal pi she'eino garf ve'eino katam, and you don't even need it to be swept aside. You don't even need to sweep aside the coals. You don't need to cover them up with ashes. Umani chananya, if that would be the case, the author of the Mishnah would actually be chananya. So the Gemara here is suggesting, this is not how we explain the Mishnah, and the Gemara is getting rejected for the obvious reason, but right now the Gemara is suggesting that the Mishnah the entire time was talking about returning it to the oven, and to put it on the oven before Shabbos, to put it on the stove before Shabbos, would for sure be okay, no matter what. You don't even need garfa katam, and that would follow the opinion of Chananya. The Tanya will end in a brisa, Chananya Omer, Chananya says, Kol shuka Michael ben Drusoy, anything that is Michael ben Drusoy is basically items that are not fully cooked, but they're partially cooked let's say, at this point, we'll say a third of the way cooked. So mutter l'shoso agave kira. Chananya says you're allowed to put those on a kira. Afa b'sheinu garf eino katam, even though it's not garf katam. So the Gemara here is suggesting maybe our Mishnah is extremely lenient, like Chananya, you don't need garf katam once it's partially cooked. Odilmor, maybe l'shos tanan. The Mishnah is talking about putting it on the stove before Shabbos. V'i garf katam in ilolo, and you do need garf katam, and it's only allowed when it's garf katam. And of course, when you're trying to return it to the flame on Shabbos, certainly you need garaf v'katam. So the Gemara brings the proof from the text of the Mishnah itself. Tashma will bring you a proof. Because there are two separate parts of this Mishnah. The first part was, that was the first part of the Mishnah. And then it said, so from the fact that the second part is talking about machzirin, the first part is probably not. That's what the Gemara elaborates upon. If the beginning of the Mishnah was talking about lishos, to place on the kira before Shabbos, so then it makes sense. Hachi katani. Here's how you read it. Kira shesikua bekashu v'gvava mashin ala tafshil begefesu ve'etzem lo yishat sheyigrov oad sheyitet efer. When you're talking about a kira which has straw or stubble, you're allowed to place stuff on before Shabbos. And when you're talking about gefes or etzem, you need to have garav v'katim. Umahin mashin, what do you put on there? What are you allowed to put on before Shabbos? Beishamay omrim chamin avalo tafshil. Beishamay say hot water but not cooked items. Beishamay omrim chamin v'tafshil. Beishamay say both hot water and cooked items. And then the Mishnah will continue. V'chihechi depligi b'lishos. Just like there's a machlokas between Beishamay and Beishamay. When it comes to lishos, pligi nami b'lahachzir. There's also a machlokas about returning it to the flame. Shabeishamay omrim notlan avalo machzir. Beishamay omrim af machzir. Beishamay say you cannot return it to the flame. Beis Hillel say you can. But the Gemara continues, if the beginning of the Mishnah is talking about returning into the flame, so here's how you're going to have to read it. So then it's saying essentially that you're not allowed to do chazar, you're not allowed to return it unless it's garf v'katzim. Uma hein machzirin, and what are you allowed to return? Beis Shammai omrim chamin avalo tavshil, or Beis Hillel chamin v'tavshil. Beis Shammai say only hot water. Beis Hillel say hot water and cooked items. Beis Shammai omrim notan avalo machzirin, or Beis Hillel omrim af machzirin. Then all of a sudden, Beis Shammai say you can't return it. Beis Hillel say you could return it. Hasu lamali. What do I need to talk about that anymore? Rashi explains. Beis Shammai omrim notan avalo machzirin al karcha atavshil kaimi. Has to be that Beis Shammai is going on Tavshil, if you're going to read it this way, because the Hasharu B'chamin, Beis Shammai already permitted you to return Chamin, so now Beis Shammai is coming around and saying, Notlin V'lo Machzirin is going on Tavshil, Hasu Lamali, why do I need to repeat myself? Hatanale Reisha V'lo Tavshil. Beis Shammai already told us in the Reisha that you cannot return a Tavshil. So again, just to restate the point, if Beis Shammai is already saying Ein Machzirin in the Reisha, why would Beis Shammai come along again and say Ein Machzirin in the Seif? So that's why the Gemara at this point wants to read it in the first way, that the beginning of the Mishnah is talking about Lishos, is talking about placing the item on the stove before Shabbos, and the end of the Mishnah is talking about Lahachzir, to return it when you took it off on Shabbos. That concludes Daf Lamed Vav Amid Beis. We'll continue with the Sugya on Daf Lamed Zayin Amid Aleph in the next video.